Some people seem so obsessed with the morning, get up early just to watch the sunrise. Some people like it more when there's fire in the sky, worship the sun when it's high. Some people go for those sultry evenings, sipping cocktails in the blue, red and gray. But I like every minute of the day. I like every second, so long as you are on my mind. Every moment has its special charm. It's alright when you're around, rain or shine. I know a crowd who only live after midnight. Their faces always seem so pale. And then there's friends of mine who must have sunlight. They say a suntan never fails. Get a buzz from being cold and wet. The pleasure seems to balance out the pain. And so you see that I'm completely crazy. I even shun the south of France. The people on the hill, they say I'm lazy, but when they sleep I sing and dance. Some people have to have the sultry evenings, cocktails in the blue, red and gray. But I like every minute of the day. I like every minute of the day.
Hello, my lovelies, out there sipping the cocktails, the blue, red, and gray. Here we are again. I'm your teacher, Andrew Hollywood, and let's learn The Blue, Red, and Gray by The Who from their album The Who by Numbers. We got a lot of chords, and let's kick it off with the intro. We've got a D chord here. Bar the index finger at the second fret. Bar means to lay your finger down flat on two or more strings of a fret, in this case all four strings of the ukulele, holding down the second fret with that finger. Stretch the pinky now to 5, fifth fret on the A string, and you've got a D chord. Our strum pattern for most of the song will consist of thumb on top, plucking a single note, plucking the G string with the thumb, then followed by a chord strum. Yeah. So you got that. Not the hardest thing in the world. Get a good even sound with the thumb note and the chord. Now, the intro in the middle part of the song and the ending that has this long D chord, you're going to have a different strum pattern. Thumb down, thumb up, down. So it's thumb down with the index finger on the chord, thumb on the single note, then up, down with the index finger again on the chord. And what you want to do on the up, down, to sound just like the song, is add your middle finger on the third fret of the E string. Yeah? So you've got the D chord, without the middle finger, thumb down, then add the middle finger, thumb up down. And some people might call this a D sus 4. Yeah, but I think you're just adding an extra note. Alright, so that's at the beginning, the middle, and the end of the song, right? At the very end, you'll end with two strums. Middle finger down, middle finger up, and then a down strum with the right index finger. Alright, but here's the verse now. We start with a G add 9. And again, the right hand's going to pretty much repeat. We've got bar 2. And we add the middle finger at the 3rd fret of the E string. And there's G add 9. All right? And 4 beats of that. 1, 2, 3, 4. A7. Bar 2. Ring finger 4C. Middle finger 3E. Pinky 4A. And you're going to do that, the G add 9 to the A7 4 times. Alright, 4 of each of those. Thumb down 4 times on each chord. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Whoopsie, I can't talk and play. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? G, 2, 3, 4. A, 2, 3, 4. Now there's a lot of hard chords in this song. If that G add 9 and the A7 like this is too hard, here's a slightly easier way to do it. We learned this way first because that's what they actually do in the song, but if you're looking for something easier, here's an option. We just do a G without the add 9. So you have an open G at the top, index finger, 2nd fret C, ring finger, 3rd fret E, middle finger, 2nd fret A. The difference in sound is this. That's G, here's G add 9. You have that different note on top. And if this A7 is too hard, then here's a very easy. Open on top, index finger, 1st fret C, then open E, open A. Very good. All right, let's keep it rolling. Now we have E minor and B back and forth. For the E minor, ring finger on top at the 4th fret, the ring finger is also going to lightly touch the C string and just mute it so there's no sound, right? You won't hear that in the chord if you properly mute it. So just lightly, practice just lightly touching a string and making sure there's no sound. Now practice holding down that note at the top and then with the pad, the soft fleshy part of your finger, just lightly touching the next string. E string is open, index finger on 2nd fret of the A string. 4 times like that. B, half bar on the 2nd fret. A half bar, we just hold down 2 strings, in this case the bottom 2 strings. Middle finger 3rd fret C, ring finger 4th fret G. 4 beats of that, then 2 beats of E minor, 2 beats of B, then E minor again, followed by G add 9, or G, A7, D. Just like at the intro, right, with the thumb down, thumb up, down. Pretty cool strum sound there. Alright, 2nd verse, different than the first. We've got G at 9 again. Moving to F sharp minor. Which, easy version, middle finger on top at 2nd fret G, index finger 1st fret C, ring finger 2nd fret E, and you can leave the A string open. If you're looking to get the exact notes that you hear on the recording, you can stretch the pinky out also to the 4th fret of the A string. Four beats of that, repeat. Two times of that, G add 9 to F sharp minor, then G add 9, F sharp, four beats, F sharp, fun one, bar 1, bar all of the strings on the 1st fret, place your ring at 3rd fret G and middle at 2nd fret E, on to B minor, 2 beats, bar 2, throw the ring finger up at the 4th fret G. If that's too much, there, again, we're just looking for easier ways to play the chords if it's too challenging for you, that still musically makes sense in the song. You could just do the B minor 7, which is bar 2 all the way, and you just need that one finger. Either B minor or B minor 7, followed by E7, 2 beats. 1st fret, 1st finger on the G string, middle finger 2nd fret C, open E, ring finger 2nd fret A, then A9, eight beats of that to end it. Alright, that's the 2nd verse. Now the 3rd verse, same as the 1st, 4th verse, same as the 2nd, 5th verse, same as the 1st, right? So 1, 3, and 5 are the same. 2 and 4 are the same. Alright, so we're plowing our way through 5, and we're at the end of 5 now. So let's say we're playing the last 3 chords of 5. G add 9. A7, right? D. Then a slightly different ending. E minor to A7. Yeah, then D. And we end with those 2 strums down with the index finger twice. Over here, barring D chord again. The 1st strum, we add the middle finger on 3rd fret E. 2nd strum, take it off. End of the song. Beautiful. So there you have it, my friends. The blue, red, and gray. I hope you're enjoying your cocktails out there, everyone. And I love this song. It's one of the best songs I've ever heard. I hope you enjoy it. See you next time.